Hey there, today we're diving into HTTP status codes. These concise responses from servers are super helpful when debugging our web apps, mobile apps, or APIs. Stick around to the end for some pro tips on how to handle these in real life. Let's start with the good ones, the 200s. These are basically the servers giving you a high five. 200 OK means everything went well on the server side. 200 created is another thumbs up for when something new was created. Say you've got an API that has user profiles. 201 created means got your data, new profile is live. But 204 no content is a little bit different. Ever send a delete request to remove some user data? 204 means it worked, but there's no content to send back. Now to the 400s, the codes that said, hey, you goofed up. These are the server's way of saying, check what you sent me. A 400 bad request is like the server asking, huh, what is this? Something in our request just doesn't make sense. A 401 unauthorized means we're missing the right credentials, like trying to get into a locked room without the key. The door won't open until the right key, or in our case, the right authentication token is provided. Then we have 403 forbidden. This one is a bit more personal. It means, I know you, but you can't come in here. Imagine having a general ticket to a concert, but trying to sneak into that VIP section. It's like trying to access admin features with a guest account. The 404 not found is the classic, the requested file ain't there. Double check those routes and endpoints. Now a status code that many developers encounter is the 429 too many requests. It's the server's way of saying, hey, slow down. We are sending requests too fast and hitting rate limits. For busy APIs, we'll need to adjust by implementing retries with backoff. Now the 500s mean something's wrong server side. These errors often require deeper investigation. They aren't always easy to spot at first glance. The 500 internal server error, that's the server's cry for help. Dig into logs for clues. 502 bad gateway hints at issues between servers, like a proxy failing to get a response. Imagine you're using Nginx as a reverse proxy, and you can't get a valid response from the application server. It would then respond with a 502. This could be due to server overloads, network glitches, or just misconfigurations. But 503 service unavailable means the server just can't handle requests right now due to maintenance or traffic overload. While both 502 and 503 hint at server issues, their origins differ. 502 is about problematic communication between servers. 503 is about the server's current state and its inability to process requests. The 300s are redirection codes. That's the web's helpful traffic controllers. 301 moved permanently is a forwarding address, with the location header pointing to the new permanent URL. 302 found is temporary. It points to a new location, but the original URL still works. 304 not modified is a cool efficiency play. The browser asks, has this changed since I cached it? 304 said, nope, you're good. This mechanism saves bandwidth and time by avoiding unnecessary redownloads. Lastly, the humble 100s don't get much attention, but are still useful, like 101 switching protocols when moving from HTTP to WebSocket. And finally, here are some pro tips. When tackling status code issues, always start with the basics. Check the request headers and body. Ensure the correct HTTP method is used and confirm the endpoint URL. Tools like Postman or Insomnia can be invaluable in testing requests and inspecting responses. And don't forget to check the server logs if you have access to them. If you like our videos, you may like our system design newsletter as well. It covers topics and trends in large-scale system design. trusted by 550,000 readers. Subscribe at blog.bybygo.com.